Welcome to Financial Buzz Market Weekly. I'm RK Walker here at the New York Stock Exchange, bringing you a review of this week's stock market. On Monday, there wasn't much economic news, and the U.S. bond market was closed due to the Columbus Day holiday. Markets were mixed as investors remained concerned over rising interest rates, a strong dollar, and rising wages. China lowered reserve requirements for its banks, causing the yuan to drop as the country tries to increase growth in the face of trade uncertainty. On Tuesday, the NFIB Small Business Optimism Index for September fell 0.9 of a point to 107.9, retreating slightly from August's record high. The IMF reduced its global growth projections, partly due to trade tensions between the U.S. and China. Markets gyrated between loss and gain to close mostly mixed. On Wednesday, the producer price index for September rose 0.2 of a percent compared to the previous month's 0.1 of a percent decline. Year over year, the PPI gained 2.6%. Fears of rising interest rates dragging down corporate earnings sparked an intense sell-off, particularly in the tech sector. The Dow Industrials fell 3.2% or 832 points, while the Nasdaq Composite lost 4% and the S&P 500 lost 3.3%. On Thursday, the consumer price index for September increased 0.1 of a percent on top of the prior month's 0.2 of a percent gain, and jobless claims for the week ending October 6 increased 7,000 to 214,000. The EIA petroleum status report for the week ending October 5 saw crude oil inventory increase 6 million barrels. The sell-off continued with the Dow Industrials closing down 545 points, the Nasdaq Composite losing 1.3%, and the S&P 500 losing 2.1%. 10-year Treasuries fell 2 basis points to 3.15%. West Texas Intermediate crude fell 3.2% to $7.87 a barrel, and gold rose 2.4% to $1,223 an ounce. On Friday, import prices for September rose 0.5% compared to the prior month's 0.4 of a percent decline, and export prices remain unchanged compared to the prior month's 0.2 of a percent drop. Markets opened strongly higher as tech stocks recovered sharply. Now let's take a look at some stocks. Sears Holdings Corporation announced on Tuesday that Alan J. Carr, managing member and CEO of Drivetrain LLC, has joined the board of directors. Carr is an investor and advisor leading complex financial restructurings. Shares of Sears reached an all-time low of 34 cents on Thursday. Fastenal Company on Wednesday announced its financial results for its third quarter. Net sales increased $147 million or 13% year-over-year, and operating income improved by 14.8% year-over-year. Fastenal shares reached a low of $50.73 on Thursday. Snap Inc. announced on Wednesday plans to produce its own new original content called Snap Originals. Investors continue to fear Snap's slowing user growth and revenue. Snap reached an all-time low of $6.46 a share on Thursday. Square Inc. announced on Wednesday that Sarah Friar will step down as chief financial officer in order to accept an offer to become chief executive officer of Nextdoor. Square reached a low of $65 per share post-announcement. Delta Airlines reported on Thursday morning its third quarter financial results with adjusted operating revenue of $11.8 billion, up $912 million or 8% year over year. Total adjusted operating expenses increased $1 billion versus a year ago, with more than half of the increase driven by higher fuel prices. Shares of Delta Airlines rose, reaching a high of $52.60 on Thursday post-announcement. This is Financial Buzz Market Weekly. I'm RK Walker, and I'll see you again next week.